Ayan, okay. So, na namin nakita karon. Okay na. Nanag yun.
Yes, sir.
Alright, sige. Dugay ako ninyo ni comment o mga sharkong pwede sa laan. Anyway, alright, sige. So, again, di ba, we have discussed trematodes. No, we are starting with the trematodes. So, your trematodes, again, are the second group of helminths or metazoa that we're going to discuss. No, so, again, atong flowchart, balik sa akong gyuma, namugna, no? So, your flowchart, metazoans, again, kamay na lang yun, no? So, here we are at the second group na, trematodes, again. And then, last na lang yun are the cestodes, alright? Cestodes, which are your tapeworms, which are we're going to discuss next week. And together with your cestodes that we discuss are the ectoparasites or your arthropods, no? So, for the ectoparasites, again, as I've mentioned, or arthropods, hindi kayo mag-in-depth, no? So, mga summarized, brief view na lang, concise na lang yun about the arthropods, mga insects. Okay. Alright, so that's our flow chart. Nato i-follow. Alright, so happy na tamang man sa paragraph, finally. Alright, okay. Now, again, general characteristics of trematodes. Ayan, as I mentioned, your trematodes are, again, in general, their appearance is flat or leaf-like. Ayan, so leaf-like, mura siya dahon, no? Flat, yun sila, flat, no? Flat, okay? Ayan. Now, they are very much different from your nematodes, which is what we discussed, no, last week. Your roundworms. No, sa pangalan pa lang, nematodes, roundworms, meaning they are really elongated and cylindrical ilang appearance, no? So, same yun sila appearance, or ilang appearance, same yun sa worms na itong nakikibalay, no? The usual appearance of a worm, di ba? Napataas and elongated, no? So, those are your nematodes. But for trematodes, they are still helminths, but again, in general, their appearance is flattened, no? Flat or leaf-like, dorsoventrally, ayan, dorsoventrally, as in like, naka-flat yun siya, no? Flat, okay? Marag mga, di ba makakita mo, flat fish, mga inana, mga fish na kanang flat yun, inana, so, mga flounder, inana. So, inana dyan lang appearance, flat, no? Dahil yun, except lang again for schistosomes, no? For the schistosoma species, because the schistosoma species are elongated or cylindrical. So, same sila appearance sa imuha mga nematodes, na pataas, mura jug worm. Mukhang schistosoma species. Okay? Now, here's a general characteristics mga kabantay mo, daghang mga except-except. Okay? And usually, ang except kay si schistosoma. Ayan. So, si schistosoma yun ang bukod na pinagpala and bukod tangi. Siya yun ang mga different characteristics sa the rest of the trematodes. Okay? Alright. Next, for their reproductive system, all your trematodes are hermaphroditic, meaning, again, in one body, they can have both the female and male reproductive systems. All right. Except again, kinsa si schistosoma. So, basta when you talk about trematodes, ang yun yung i-remember or ang mga distinct or mga press the buzzer yun dayon is ang schistosoma yun ang mga except. Siya yun ang mo differ, no? Siya yun ang magpabibo. Siya yun ang mulahi. All right. Okay. Ayan. Now again, hermaphroditic imuhang trematodes except for schistosoma because the schistosoma species are dioecious. So, similar siya with the nematodes na dioecious, meaning separate ilahang sexes. So, meaning one worm is male, another worm is female. So, separate yun siya. Okay? Next, for the eggs are operculated, no? Most of your trematodes, again, except the kinsa, schistosoma. Ayan. They're all operculated. So, when you say operculated, their eggs has an operculum. Diba? Remember, ang meaning sa operculum. Your operculum is a parang opening, no? Or a hatch, a lid, no? Or taklob, ayan, taklob, no? Sa imuhang egg. Okay, so ito nag-draw na lang. Okay, sorry ang pangitang drawing ko. Ayan, so kinani ang egg, no? And then at the taas, there is a hatch or lid, na taklob, alright? And this taklob is known as the operculum. And this operculum opens, okay, when the larva inside the egg goes out. Okay? So again, operculum is parang a hatch or a lid, a taklob, alright, na mo-open, okay, mo-open siya if, again, if the larva goes out from the inside of the egg. Okay? Alright, ayan, sige. So those are the first general characteristics of your trematodes. Okay, sige. Alright, sige. Next, we go now to your life cycle. Now, for the life cycle of your trematodes, it still follows your nematodes na mag-start ng egg, followed by the egg is the larva, and then finally, the adult. Now, the difference lang is that ang ihang larval stages different, no? Lahi iyang mga ngalan. Sa nematodes, di ba, nato yung L1, L2, L3, L4, rhabditiform, filariform. But for trematodes, ayan, we have here the stages. It starts first as a miracidium, followed by a sporocyst, then a redia, followed by a cercaria, and finally, the meta Cercaria or Metacercariae. Okay. Now again, kisa siya pa exception, si Schistosomes. Because Schistosoma, puto bra siya, Cercaria. Wala siya yung Metacercaria. And actually, sa Schistosomes po, please take note, wala po siya yung Redia. Okay? So instead of Redia, ikaduha siya mag-sporocyst. Okay? So again, for Schistosomes, wala siya yung Metacercaria, wala po siya yung Redia. Instead of Redia, no, instead of Redia, ang sporocyst, ikaduha siya mag-sporocyst. Okay? Get? So, for Schistosoma, Miracidium, M, then followed by sporocyst na twice, and then after sporocyst na twice, kay Cercaria na. Okay? So, wala siya yung Metacercaria, wala po siya yung Redia. Okay? Alright. So, how do we remember the larval stages? So, naku yung mnemonics din. Okay? Credits to Osaka lecturer sa Pioneer na Review Center. So, ang atong mnemonics for that is, wait, what's on here, right? Very effective, good, as can promise. Alright, so atong mnemonics to remember the larva, unsa man, Miss R.C. Munoz. Ayan, sorry naman, medyo funny, no, pero effective. Ayan, sige. So, Miss R.C. Munoz. So, how do we remember? M, mag-start. M for Miracidium. S for sporocyst, followed by R, Redia. And then C for Cercaria. And then lastly, of course, letter M is Metacercariae. So this is the larval stages of all the trematodes, except kinsa gani Japon, si Schistosomes. Your Schistosomes, again, puto brag, Cercaria. Okay? Alright? And wala po siya R, wala siya Redia. Okay? Alright, so ano ra si Schistosoma MSC. So Meseliman committee siya. Okay? MSC ra siya. Miracidium, sporocyst twice siya mag-sporocyst, and then finally, Cercaria. So MSC, si Schistosomes. The rest of your trematodes, aside from Schistosomes, kay Miss R.C. Munoz na, di ba? Very effective. Ganang kikuha niya na mnemonic yun. So, Miss R.C. Munoz, yes. Miracidium, sporocyst, Redia, Cercaria, and then finally, the Metacercaria. Okay? Take note of that, di ba? That's our mnemonic. First mnemonic na ako na-share sa trematodes. Okay. Alright, so that's for the larval stages. Now, again, usually, what happens is, kaning RC, alright, the S and R, the SR, usually mahitabo siya sa snail, okay? Sa snail, sa yung first intermediate host, alright? And then after that, the Cercaria will go out of the snail, alright, usually sa water, and then mahimo siyang Metacercaria sa yung second intermediate host, okay? And usually, the Metacercariae is the infective stage. So, ayan, next bullet. Infective stage of the final host is the M, Munoz, Metacercaria. Except again for, ayan, Schistosomes or Gepon. Because remember, ano man, Schistosomes do not have Metacercaria. Ang pinakalast na larval stage ni Schistosomes is your C, Cercaria. So sa Cercaria, muna infective stage ni Schistosoma. Please take note ha, all trematodes, alright, are, yung infective stage are, or is, your Metacercaria except for Schistosomes. Because in sa infective stage of Schistosomes, Cercaria. Okay, alright. Now, the mode of transmission, again, for the rest of your trematodes is usually through ingestion, okay, of the second intermediate host. But for your Schistosomes, siya po yung lahat, skin penetration. Okay, diba? So, as I mentioned, daghan yung exception si Schistosoma. So, Schistosoma yun ang magpalahit, no? Ayan, siya yun ang magpabibo. Kaya siya ang lahit. Okay, so Schistosoma, skin penetration. Okay. Alright, sige. Now, take note again, dear, so for the larval stages, diba, Miracidium, muna siya ang sulod sa egg. Okay? Muna siya sulod sa egg. Now, there are some species of trematodes na before siya mahimong sporocyst, kailangan sa siya makaon sa snail or sa first intermediate host. Meaning, kailangan ang egg muna makaon sa snail, alright, before mu-hatch ang Miracidium. Okay? Napo yung bang species of trematodes na pag contact sa water, ang egg kay mu-hatch agad-agad. Okay? So, ang imuhang Miracidium, mugawas na yun. Okay? Alright. So, there are some trematode species na inana. Okay, depende siya sa trematode species. Again, there are some trematode species na the Miracidium hatches only when the first intermediate host, which is usually a snail, ingests the egg of the trematode, or na ibang trematode species na the eggs or the Miracidium hatches once in the water. Mahalag wala pa siya nakaon sa snail. Alright, nagets lang? Okay, so depende siya sa trematode species. Alright, okay. Ayan, sige. So here are some pictures. Okay, present. Na-gymrag na show ko sa appearance dear sa single ko nag-expect. Okay. Ayan. So here's an example, your Miracidium. As you can see, your Miracidium is ciliated. Na siya cilia. So it is motile, no? So muli-mulihok siya, of course. Ayan, Miracidium. Followed by the sporocyst. So ang sporocyst, as you can see, medyo elongated na siya. And ang sunod anak, kaya the developing na ng mga organs and structures of your trematodes. Of course, followed by S is your radii. Ayan, guys, may God, medyo na-shook. Oh, bakit ganito yung appearance? May nire-remember ako, it looks familiar. Sounds family. Looks family. So, ayan. So, that is a picture of radii. So, elongated radii po siya. Pero, it looks different talaga. As in, I miss. Okay. So, radii, no? So, illustration to siya. This is the real picture. So, elongated radii po siya, no? It's still developing sulod. So, the sulod are the developing organs and structures of your trematodes. Followed by, of course, your letter C, your circaria. Now, your circaria can be of different appearances, no? Pwede siyang mo-assume of different structures or different appearances. So this one, dears, is the circaria of Paragonimus westermanni. The circaria of Paragonimus westermanni is described as microcircus. Wait, let me write. Ayan. So microcircus, okay? Microcircus. Why? Look at the picture, di ba? Little kani siya. This is the tail, di ba? And most of your circaria manggute swim padulong sa second intermediate host. But for Paragonimus westermanni, because gamay kay ang tail, ang iyang buhaton kay sa rocks siya sa water or sa river, mag-crawl na siya dito padulong sa iyang second intermediate host. Di ba? Ka-cute, charot. So mag-crawl siya sa surface of rocks in rivers or sa waters because again, gamay kay siya tail. Ayan, this one. This is known as microcircus, no? Microcircus, gamay siya ang tail, all right? Next, this is the circaria of the rest of your trematodes most of the time. And this is known as gymnocephalus, no? Gymnocephalus, meaning dako siyang head, okay? And then one ka-tail. So this is motil, mulihok na siya, all right? And muanto siya siyang second intermediate host, okay? So again, this is your tail and this is the head. So gymnocephalus. And this one, wala lang, i-rank ko super. Ayan. Gymnocephalus. Ayan. Gymnocephalus. Okay? Kani siyang nasa pinaka-right. And then lastly, kanang nasa pinaka-ilalong, that is your fourth tail circaria or furcocircus. Muna siya circaria sa mga schistosomes. Alright? So, furcocircus or fourth tail circaria. Munishai, circaria simuhang, schistosoma species. All of your schistosoma species, kinanilang appearance, no? Furcocircus or fourth tail, no? As you can see, kita mo siyang tail, no? Nasa picture. Kani siya ang tail, fourth, no? Na ay duha ka fork or duha ka arms, no? Ayan, so fourth tail circaria. Okay, alright. And the last, no? For your larval stages is the metacircaria. Now again, ang schistosoma na ba ani or wala? Naa or wala? Ang schistosoma
wala.
Ani? Okay, very good. No, so wala sila yung metacircaria. So imo ang schistosoma, kutubra, diri lang siya taman, diri lang siya kutob, charot. So diri ra kutob imo ang schistosoma. For the rest of your trematodes, they have this last larval stage, and that is the metacircaria. And this is the infective stage of the rest of your trematodes to humans and to the rest of the possible affected na mga animals. Okay? So, kani siya na metacircaria, they insist, okay, or mahimus lang in ani, on the different second intermediate host. May it be fish, may it be mga plants, water vegetation, or other second intermediate hosts. Okay? Alright, so those are the larval stages. Again, sa tonimonics, Miss RC Munoz. Sorry naman, Miss RC Munoz. Nagamit as mnemonics. Pero effective naman, di ba? Miss RC Munoz. But again, except for schistosoma, because ang schistosoma yung larval stages rakay, MS squared C. So, Miss Saliman Committee. MSC because M, miracidium, S, sporocyst, no? Twice siya mag-sporocyst, and then finally, C, circaria. Alright, okay, sige. Next, we go now to your intermediate hosts. Ayan, so, dire mo, different na po sila. All of your trematodes require two intermediate hosts, okay? Duha ka intermediate hosts. The first intermediate host is always good, a snail, okay? Alright, ayan. First intermediate host is always a snail, alright? So again, all your trematodes have two intermediate hosts, except Japon for schistosoma. Because ang schistosoma, okay na niyang usa intermediate host, okay? And that is a snail. But for the rest of your trematodes, aside from schistosoma, they have two intermediate host. The first intermediate host is always a snail, and the second intermediate host, dira na siya mo vary. Pwedeng fish, pwedeng crabs, pwedeng ant, pwedeng plants, pwede pong another snail, alright? Depending on the species of trematodes, alright? Nag-gets ra. So, sa first intermediate host, dira yun sila mag-similar sa tanang trematodes. Snail yun sila mag-sukad, manukad, or dito sila mag-start. The second intermediate host, dito na sila mo differ, okay? Depending sa species, pwede again plants or water plants, water vegetation, pwedeng crabs, pwedeng fish, pwedeng ants, pwedeng another snail, alright? Okay, so here is a summary. Kinsa ng mga fish ang second intermediate host, the heterophids, your heterophys, metagonimus, ay joke, sorry. Tama, heterophys, the clonorchis, opistorchids na family, opistorchis filineus. For the crab is, of course, paragonimus, westermani. For plants, the fasciola and fasciolopsis. For snail is echinostoma. And for ants is dicrocilium dendriticum and eurythrema pancreaticum. Ayan. So, depende siya sa imuhang species kung kinsayahan second intermediate host. But again, for schistosoma, hindi na siya kailangan og second intermediate host. Okay? Kutom ra siya first intermediate host, and that is the snail. Alright? Please take note. Okay, I hope nag-gets right to siya. Alright, sige. Alright. Now, Okay. Now, another one, parts of the adults, no? So, the adults mismo, they have suckers. Ayan. So, mahilig sila mag-suck, of course. So, they have suckers, no? Oh my God, it's raining. So, they have suckers. Most of the adults have, again, two suckers. You have the oral sucker and you have the ventral sucker. Usually, these suckers are for point of attachment, no? So, ginagamit na nila for attachment, okay? So you have the oral sucker and the ventral sucker, okay? But for the heterophys, dira na siya mo differ because the heterophys has a third sucker, which is known as the genital sucker, usually found in the genital pore. This genital sucker or gonotyle is used for copulatory purposes, no, for reproduction, all right? Okay, so that's for the suckers. Ayan, suckers, Yeah, I missed it. Okay, so suckers, no? You have, again, the oral sucker and the ventral sucker. So oral sucker is where the food enters, okay? This is a point of nourishment nila. The ventral sucker is for attachment purposes, okay? Para ma-attach siya sa wall of the host. All right, wait lang, there's a home connection. Okay pa ba? Can you still hear me? Okay ra?
Yes, sir.
All right, sige. Please inform me ha if mo choppy or whatever, sige. Now, when we go to eggs, okay. Now, eggs, depende siya on the maturity or immaturity pag late sa gawas, no? If mature na siya dahil pag gawas, no, infected na siya dahil, nanay miracidium na nasa sulod, you have shock, no? Schistosoma, heterophys, opistorchis, and clonorchis. Sila upat, no? Ilahang eggs pag gawas sa environment, nanay miracidium dahil sa sulod, okay? For immature when laid, you have fasciola, fasciolopsis, paragonimus, and echinostoma, FFPE, no? So, ano lang, FFPE, atong mnemonics for that, immature when laid. Meaning, pagawas pa lang nila, the egg is still immature. Wala pa yung sulod na miracidium. Okay, so mature pa siya sa water or sa environment. Okay, nag-gets lang. So mature when laid, meaning sa sulod sa egg, kay nanay miracidium agad-agad, is shock. No, I'm so shocked. No? Ayan. So, schistosoma, heterophys, opistorchis, and clonorchis. Immature when laid, again, you have FFPE. Meaning, ang ilahang egg sa sulod, wala pa yung nag-develop na miracidium or wala pa yung miracidium agad. Okay. Siya, alright? Pero wala siya anus. Wala siya anus. Okay. So, wala man siya anus. That's why, kung nasa mga waste products from the food na yung ikaon, wala niya na-digest, sa mouth mo gawas. No? Imagine na, yun. Imagine na yung pang-entrance mo gawas sa mouth. So, dito siya, dito muna yung mahitabo sa trematodes, no? So, katong mga undigested food na yung ikaon, sa mouth mo gawas, kaya wala siya anus. Alright. Now, it has complex reproductive structures, both testes, ovary, and uterus. Okay? Alright. Because again, as we have mentioned, most of the trematodes are monoecious, meaning they have both the reproductive system, reproductive organs of males and females together in one body. Okay? And then we also have this vitellaria. Alright? These vitellaria are glands, no? That provide the ingredients, in a way, or the structures, or the necessary ingredients for egg formation, for the shell formation of the egg. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Sige. So, that's for vitellaria. Alright. So, sa general characteristics pa lang daan, dears, daghan na kaayo kang pwedeng ma-ask sa exam, and daghan na kang pwedeng ma-remember, no? Basta ang general concept lang yun is tanang trematodes, similar o characteristics most of the time, except for, kinsaman, si schistosoma. Si schistosoma yun ang modifier, no? Siya yun ang magpalahi, okay? So, infective stage, yung appearance, and all that, tanan-tanan yun, the rest of the trematodes have similar appearances and ilha mga pinagdadaanan similar po, except for schistosoma. So, that's what you have to remember yun. Ang schistosoma yun ang mo-exempt. Okay? Siya yun ang exception. The only exception by paramour. Okay? Si schistosoma. Okay? Alright. Ayan. Now, here's an example of an adult trematode. Okay. Now, very complex ilang structure actually. Medyo dagan kayong sulod, no? But ako lang i-point yung mga important stuff. So, you have the anterior sucker or also known as the oral sucker. Okay? Which is, again, the mouth. This is where the food enters, yung ginakaon, alright, dira mo sulod. Next, you have the ventral sucker, also known as acetabulum. Ayan. Wala po i-write. Acetabulum, take note of that term, dears, kinana po na sa mga cestodes. Ang acetabulum, alright, that's the ventral sucker, alright. So, when you say ventral, kaya diba sa, nasa body. Ayan, so ventral sucker, acetabulum, ang other name. Again, the main purpose of that is for attachment purposes. For the intestine, here as you can see, known as the cecum or cica. Ayan, wala siya lubot, diba? Wala siya lubot. Okay, so after niyang kahon, if na mga undigested stuff, mugawa siya po siya sa mouth, diba? Ayan, next, you can see here, this one, the pink or uterus, diba? Marasyag ka ng isaw, no? Sarap. Okay, marasyag isaw that contains the eggs, uterus containing the eggs. You have a testes, usually ang testes kay posterior, meaning nasa sa likod. And then the ovary ang nasa tubangan, anterior, no? So siya ang nasa tubangan. Alright, and then they have structures there na mag-meet sila, alright, para ma-fertilize ang egg and sperm, of course. And then sa uterus, ma-produce ang eggs. And the eggs are released through the genital pore, okay? So ang eggs na ma-produce are released through the genital pore. This excretory pore, usually kay sa mga liquid waste nila, so mga ihi, no, excretory bladder. Some of their wastes are also diffused outside of the skin, no, through the skin, silang tegument. Okay, tegument. Alright, sige. Now, dito sa kilid, these are the vitellaria or yolk gland, yolk duct. Again, the purpose of vitellaria is to provide, no, the nutrients or the components of eggshells, no, for the formation of eggshells. Alright? The shells of the eggs na ma-produce. Alright? So, that's the parts of your trematodes. Okay? Oral sucker. Alright? Again, oral sucker, point of entry, yahang mouth, dira siya mukhaon. Ventral sucker is again for attachment. So, di ba? Sucker. Ventral sucker. No? Sana ko, nagsasuck. Charot. So, by the name itself, naman sila yung mga suckers. Meaning, for attachment, they suck. Okay? They suck on the surface, no, of the host. Alright? Okay. They suck on the surface of the host. Alright. Okay. Sige. So, that is why also the ideas, no, your trematodes, they have a lot of subclasses, no? But the most important, or atong gina-focus, is the digenia, alright? Digenia subclass, or digenetic, so, alright? Digenia, or digenetic. Alright, so digenia, or digenetic, this is the subclass of trematodes where most of your parasitic trematodes can be found, okay? Because again, digenia, when you say di, it requires two intermediate hosts, no? Ayan, digenia or digenetic. That's the subclass of trematodes where makita na mga parasitic trematodes. And this is what we're focusing in our lecture, okay? So digenia, digenetic, two intermediate hosts. Aside from that, they're also capable of producing sexual reproduction, ayan, pag-produce ng eggs, or asexual, ilang mga larval stages, alright? Which happens in the seal, okay, usually. Alright? Sige. Okay, so that's for the trematodes and general characteristics. Okay, so before I proceed to the first group of your flukes or your trematodes that are medically important, do you have any questions? Right? No? Yes. Okay. Again, on some infective stage, ato ang mga trematodes. Yes, okay. What's the infective stage of the mga trematodes?
Metacercaria.
Okay, metacercaria. All right. Now, kinsa man tong ang infective stage atong schistosoma?
Cercaria, sir.
Very good. All right. And again, sa atong always first intermediate host for the trematodes?
Snails.
Snails. All right. And the second intermediate host, siya ang siya ang first, again, first intermediate host are the snails, and the second intermediate host, dito sila mag-vary, okay? So, pwedeng fish, pwedeng plants or vegetation, pwede po mga ants, no? Depending on the species, okay? Alright, so, ayan, so that's for the general characteristics. Okay, sige. So, we now proceed to the first group of your flukes, and that is your liver fluke. So, by the name itself, no? These are flukes that reside in the liver, parts of the liver, no? Mga ducts sa liver, sa gallbladder, etc. And of course, most of their symptoms are liver-related. Okay, so mga hepatic, no? Or mga cholangio, no? Sa gallbladder-related. Okay, alright. And we're going to start first with your fasciola hepatica. Okay, so fasciola hepatica by the name itself, sa liver, no? Fasciola. Now, this is known as your sheep liver fluke, alright? Which causes liver rot in sheep, okay? And usually, these are prevalent in countries na nai sheep. Nor ng alaga og sheep. So fasciola hepatica is very, very dangerous or very, it causes great economic loss among mga countries na daghang sheep. Kay mamatay ang sheep because of that, no? So, and fasciola is the most common or the most important helminth infection among sheep, no? Your fasciola. Because again, it can cause, ayan, sheep liver rot. So this is an example of a sheep liver. After autopsy na yung mga sheep liver rot. So as you can see, na yung mga busot-busot niya ng sheep, agi sa imuhang trematode na fasciola, yung sa adult trematode. Okay? Alright. This was the first trematode to be described and in which the entire life cycle is also described or defined. Okay. Now again, common name is the sheep liver fluke or the temperate liver fluke because it's the liver fluke that can survive mga cold temperatures, no? Or common in mga countries where the temperatures are not quite high, no? Dito kay init, so moderate lang, temperate. Or kato mga codes sa America, no, sa Europe, etc. Okay. Now, final host is the sheep, but, ayan, pwede siyang other herbivores such as goats, cattle, horses, camels, hogs, rabbits, and deer. Because again, how do they acquire that? It's through ingestion of the second intermediate host. And so, natin second intermediate host, mga plants, no, or vegetation. So, an example of that is kangkong, ayan. So, Ipomea obscura or Ipomea aquatica. Okay, so mga kangkong, water spinach, basta mga plants and as a water. Okay? Alright. First intermediate host is still the snail. Alright? And ang species niya kay Limnea or Limnea species. Okay? Infective stage is again, Metasercaria because again, this is the normal na mga trematodes. Hindi naman siya schistosoma, di ba? So, infective stage is Metasercaria and of course, mode of transmission is ingestion of the second intermediate host, which is again, the plants or vegetation, water plants. Okay? Alright, ayan. Now, habitat, asa siya makita? Sa biliary duct, alright? Or sa liver, passages of the liver. Okay, alright. So again, that's for fasciola hepatica. So again, so far naman sa boards, wala sila ni ask kung kunsa na mga species ang imong intermediate host. No? So thankfully, wala sila nangunta ng species. No? Ang ilang nangunta na kay, what is the first intermediate host example? What is the intermediate host or what is the second intermediate host of fasciola hepatica? Ang choice sa anak kay A, plants, B, fish, inanala na siya. So, wala siya species. So, thank God. No, so far, alright? But again, at least aware ta sa mga species. Possible, what if they, I know, ganahan silang i-ask. So, at least aware ta. Okay, alright. So, that's for the general information about fasciola hepatica. So, again, here are some pictures. Water spinach or your kangkong. Possible po ng watercress. So again, these are plants that reside in water. No, usually sa mga rivers, no, or freshwater, no, na mga streams and all that. Okay, and of course, there are some dishes in the world, especially here in the Philippines, po, that we eat them raw, di ba? Like mga salads or yun sa mga pagluto, basta dili siya raw, dili siya cooked well. Okay, so that's how we get the infection, ingestion of undercooked or raw, the second intermediate host. Okay? Alright, that's for fasciola hepatica. Now, for the adults, as you can see, it's large, okay? Large, broad, oval ang body. And a very, very important characteristic is your cephalic cone. Ayan, this one. When you say cephalic cone sa head, no? Kani siya na part, di ba? Mara siya cone, di ba? Cone, di ba? Cone iya hang appearance. And na siya prominent na shoulders. Ayan, na siya shoulders, no? Diba? Sana all na yung shoulders. Okay, so na siya yung shoulders. Okay, prominent shoulders, cephalic cone. Alright? And the testes are highly branched. Ovaries are dendritic. Okay, so, dilidapit na yung parts later. Na dilidapit ang testes niya. Alright? And the ovaries kay na dilidapit sa atubangan. Okay? Alright. So again, very important, prominent shoulder, no? Well-defined or well-developed shoulder. Okay, yahang adults. Alright. And for the eggs, adults pa rin. So this is the parts of your adult fasciola hepatica. Oral sucker, the mouth, ventral sucker, okay? And then you have here the intestines, ovary, and then the testes nasa likod. And then nasa kilid kay mga vitellaria. Alright? Okay. Any serous dideres, alright? I forgot to mention, serous is the parang penis na organ sa imuhang fasciola or sa imuhang trematod. Okay? Serous ang tawag. Okay? Serous. Alright? Why so serous? Okay. Sige. Now, for the eggs, ayan, it's very large. And of course, as we have mentioned, it's operculated. Pero, it's not embryonated when laid. Okay? So, meaning, ang sulod niya, pares ani, it's just an unsegmented mass. Murara siya mass, no? Of embryo. Unlike your other, again, mga mature when laid, ang sulod na yun kay miracidium, the first larval stage. Okay. Now, very important, fasciola hepatica, similar siya appearance with the eggs of Fasciolopsis and also Fasciola gigantica. So, meaning, possible na result siya i-distinguish yun. Actually, eggs of Fasciola and Fasciolopsis are indistinguishable from each other. Please take note of that. Okay? So, hindi siya ma-identify through, mag-result kang identify through eggs alone. Alright? Okay. Now, it resembles a hen's egg appearance or hen's egg. No, katong normal na egg na to, di ba, na ginagamit. So, meron siya ginana yung appearance. Okay? Alright. Now, for the life cycle of your Fasciola species, may it be Fasciola gigantica or Fasciola hepatica. Again, the eggs are released, no, unembryonated, alright? And once in contact with water, it matures and develops the first larva, which is your miracidia. Now, the miracidia will hatch out of the egg sa water. It will swim padulong sa first intermediate host, which is the snail, alright? Now, inside the snail, the miracidium develops again into the larval stages, sporocyst, redia, and then finally, cercaria. The cercaria, again, is motile. Mugawa siya sa snail. Based sa akong naibalhan, iyang i-burst ang snail, no? Ang cercaria, luwi kayo. So, iyang i-burst ang snail, mugawas ang cercaria. And the cercaria will swim, again, padulong sa second intermediate host, which is your plants, okay, or vegetation. And sa plants, mu-insist siya, okay, may mo siyang cyst structure, and that is known now as the metacercaria. This metacercaria will then be eaten by your, again, cows or sheep or by us, humans, alright? And inside the humans, again, metacercaria will exist, mugawa siya sa cyst na structure, and become adult trematodes and produce eggs, okay? And the cycle goes on, alright? So that's for the life cycle of the Fasciola species, hepatica or gigantica, okay? Now, before we proceed to the symptoms, ato sang i-review ng inyong liver. Kaya mo man siya yung kinaapektuhan niya, no? So, for the liver, as you can see, remember these mga ducts, okay? So, sa liver, your gallbladder is again under the liver, alright, and contains a lot of ducts, no? So, you have the cystic duct, common bile duct, okay? And then you have the duodenum here, of course, and you have ducts from the gallbladder and pancreas na medyo mag-merge sila. Alright, so possible na if ma-affected ang gallbladder or ma-affected ang ducts, pwede pong ma-affected ang pancreas. Okay? So again, the ducts and then the liver. Alright? So please take note of kanyang mga parts, no? Inyong anatomy, yes. Alright, so kayo muna siya ma-affected sa inyong mga liver flukes. Alright. Now we go back to the symptoms and pathology of fasciolysis. Now, the stages of symptoms usually are divided into two phases, the chronic and acute. For acute phase, again, once makauna sa patient ay mga metacercaria, the metacercaria will again exist, mugawa siya. And this metacercaria is again active larva. Mumigrate siya to other tissues, iyahang i-penetrate, no, ang mga intestinal wall. And once ma-penetrate niya intestinal wall niya sa patient, mu-spread siya sa peritoneal cavity until maabot siya sa liver. Okay, ayan. And in the liver, iyahang buslutan. Again, iyang i-burrow ang liver parenchyma. Okay? The patient can be asymptomatic, pero there is a diagnostic significance tulo ka buo. There could be high fever, hepatomegaly, of course, and marked eosinophilia. Alright? Now, for chronic phase, the chronic phase happens if the adult worms reach the bile ducts. Dito sila mo establish o chronicity. Dito na sila mo live for a long period of time. Alright? Now, since nasa sa bile duct, of course, it can cause mga obstruction and inflammation in the biliary epithelium, leading to fibrosis. So, sa bile ducts, mag-cause of infection, it could lead to biliary obstruction again and cholangitis. So, here's a picture, as you can see, this is the adult trematode, ayan, of Fasciola hepatica, na nakitaan sa liver, ayan, di ba? So, as you can see, it's moving, and flat yung siya in appearance, alright? So, kanina sa taas, there, is the oral sucker, alright, yung mouth. And then may siya sa liver nakitaan. Okay? Alright, so it's moving. Ayan. Meron siya leaf, no? It's flat in appearance. Okay? Alright. Sige. Next, you have, again, if the flukes are in the extrahepatic biliary ducts, then the symptoms could be similar to cholelithiasis, lithiasis, or gallstones, no? Recognize experience na gallstones. Rare complication is, again, acute pancreatitis, possible that the adult trematodes can reach the pancreas. Because, again, based ato picture sa anatomy sa liver, di ba, na ay mga ducts na nag-connect sa gallbladder and sa pancreas. Okay. Number five is your Halzun, or found in Lebanon. No, Halzun syndrome. Because in these areas, they like to eat raw na goat or sheep na liver. Now, pagkaon nila sa goat or sheep na liver na raw, possible na, basi na yung mga adult trematodes dito, o fasciola. So, pagkaon nila, the adult trematodes can attach, no, on the pharynx, among throat, no, and can cause suffocation, alright, and can lead to dysphagia, no, deafness, sa imuhang diri sa throat, and all that. But it's transient lang, pero siyang mawala, okay? Alright, but this is called Halzun syndrome, alright, or in Sudan, it's known as Marara, okay, Marara. Okay, by bad romance, charot. Okay, ayun. Halzun syndrome or Marara. Okay, so here's an example. This is the adult trematode found in the voice box. Okay, after eating, again, raw sheep or goat na liver that may contain the adult fasciola hepatica. Okay, alright, sige. Yes, alright. Kaya today, okay pa ba mo? Okay, laban lang yung tanong. Alright, sige. Next, you have for the lab DX. Of course, for presumptive diagnosis, stool examination, we look for eggs. And then, of course, we can also have ELISA, serological test. For confirmation, it's more on radiographic techniques, no? So X-ray, CT scan, and magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, to look for mga lesions sa liver, all right? Or possible na mga damages dito sa gallbladder and all that. Okay. Now, for stool examination, for the trematodes, the ideas, okay, please take note. For the trematodes, usually ato yung main morphologic diagnostic stage is the eggs, no? Because the adult worms, adult flukes usually are seldom recovered, okay? And these adults, because again, di ba, they attach, musak man sila, di ba? Sana all. Musak sila sa surface of the host, no? Ma-attach sila dito, no? So, they can be found only in the liver, no, or sa mga tissue biopsy, ang mga adults. But most of the time, ato yung diagnostic stage kaysa eggs, alright, or ang eggs, alright. Now, routine ONP examination, of course, multiple samples may be recommended because again, para higher chances of recovering, or possible po na gamay ang eggs pa na makita, especially if light infections. Again, you can process it in wet mounts, you can add iodine or not, but if you want to add iodine, it should be little lang because the eggs tend to be stained darkly, alright? Okay, ayan. And you must examine it under LPO, okay? Because the eggs are large, so makita ra siya daan. Alright. Now, sedimentation techniques, of course, ang preferred nato is your FECT, alright? Sedimentation techniques, because again, the eggs will not float using your zinc sulfate flotation, alright? And spurious infection, again, same sa Halzun, spurious, nakakaon ra ka liver na infected with fasciola adult. So you have to differentiate spurious infection from real infection by fasciola hepatica. So how we differentiate? You let the patient have a liver-free diet, meaning pakanon yung mga patient o food na free sa liver, no? And after mga for mga 3 days, no? And after 3 days, lantawan mo yung stool. If nadya po yung eggs sa fasciola, then that would mean that the patient is really having a true infection of fasciola. Pero if wala na, no, it means lang na katong fasciola na na-recover initially sa yung stool, it came from the food that he or she ate, okay, which is usually infected liver, okay? Alright. Serological test, again, ELISA, counter electrophoresis, immunoblots. The test of choice, again, if negative siya for stool exam, no, both acute or chronic disease. For liver biopsy, again, it's usually used for diagnosing asymptomatic disease, alright? And the treatment of choice nato, dears, is triclabendazole. Pwede po siyang bithionol, ayan, this one, bithionol, because bithionol is more readily available compared to triclabendazole. Okay? Please take note of that. Alright, so that's for fasciola hepatica. Okay? Alright, see. Any questions before we continue? Okay pa ba tayo, dears? Medyo nakafeel ko na I'm so drained. Feel ako drained po mo. So, lampan lang yung Lunes pa, no? Lunes pa, pero lampan lang. Okay. Alright, see. Any questions for fasciola hepatica? What we have to remember lang again, common names, ha? Common names, sheep liver fluke or your temperate liver fluke, The intermediate host, snail, and unsa intermediate host niya? Plants, okay? Water plants, vegetation, all right? And again, iha mga diseases. Halzun syndrome, Halzun, okay? Halzun, Halzun, or marara, okay? And of course, sheep liver rot. Katong liver rot, may tabo siya sa sheep, okay? All right, ayun, sige. But again, generally, no, the infections or symptoms presented by the patient depends on worm burden. Kung gaano kadaghan, no? If daghan ang worms na naa, of course, then mas intense ang symptoms. Pero if light lang, gamay ra, then mas light ra ang symptoms. Okay? Alright. So that's for Fasciola hepatica, the first Fasciola species. Next, you have Fasciola gigantica. Now, by the name itself, gigant, no, malaki siya, dax, charot. Now, it infects the cattle in the Philippines. Ito yung meron tayo, no? Fasciola gigantica. It's a dominant species affecting cattle and water buffaloes in the Philippines. So, yeah, common name, giant liver fluke or the tropical liver fluke. Because in contrast, no, or in opposite, no, opposite to your Fasciola hepatica, these Fasciola species reside best or mas grand sila if sa tropical. Mas makasurvive sa tropical na mga countries. So, sa Philippines, no, sa Southeast Asia and all that. Alright? So, giant liver fluke, ayan, nasa pangalan na. Habitat is still the same, biliary passages of liver. Final host is your cattle. First intermediate host is snail. Second intermediate host, same ragyapon with your Fasciola hepatica, water plant vegetation. Infective stage, intermediate mode of transmission, same ragyapon. Metasercaria, ingestion of the second intermediate host. Okay, all right. Now for the adult, as you can see, it's quite longer, all right? Longer siya, and as you can see, wala siya prominent shoulders. Unlike for Fasciola hepatica, as you can see, di ba, makita nyo mo ang shoulder. Ayan, makita nyo mo ang shoulder. But for Fasciola gigantica, it's much longer and mas dili prominent iyahang shoulders. Okay? Alright. Now, almost same with F. hepatica, but again, nasa pangalan na, gigantica, it's much bigger. Okay? So, mas dax siya. Sana all. Now, for the eggs, as I have mentioned, Fasciola hepatica and Fasciola gigantica na eggs are similar. Alright? But again, the eggs can be larger. Nasa pangalan na, gigantica. Okay? But again, as I have mentioned, Fasciola, Fasciolopsis, na mga eggs are indistinguishable from each other, meaning hindi mo siya ma-differentiate yun by eggs. So how do we differentiate? It's usually through adults, okay? If ma-recover na to siya. And of course, history. No, patient history. And also area of infection or site of infection in the body. If the infection happens in the liver, then that's possibly Fasciola species. But if sa intestine na hitabo, then that's Fasciolopsis. Okay? Because again, later sa intestinal flukes, your Fasciolopsis, okay, affects the intestine. Alright? Okay, thank you. Now, life cycle, as I mentioned na, same rajapon with Fasciola hepatica. Alright? Now, for symptoms and pathology, similar rajapon to F. hepatica, patient may experience fever, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, hepatomegaly, hepatic tenderness, and eosinophilia. There could be abscess or tumor-like reactions in subcutaneous tissues also, or in the liver. Okay, alright. Because again, as I have mentioned, diba, once makaon na sa patient ang metasercaria, the metasercaria will exist. Mugawa siya sa cyst na structure, and the metasercaria will migrate, no? Yang ibuslutan or mo-penetrate siya sa imuhang intestinal wall, and it spreads sa peritoneal cavity. Okay? Now, if the metasercaria will penetrate a blood vessel, ayan, sa imuhang intestine, possible yun siya na ma-spread to the other organs of the body, pwede sa brain, pwede sa other organs, hematogenously. But again, that's not common. Okay, medyo rare lang. Alright, so possible na maabot siya sa skin and causing subcutaneous tissues. Alright, pero iyang general area yun or organ na asa siya mo reside is sa liver. Okay? Alright, ayan, sige. Now for lab BX, similar gapon with F. hepatica, eggs are more absent in infections with F. hepatica. Mas less ang eggs na makita nimo or seldom na makita ng eggs. So, multiple samples are still required. And of course, as I mentioned, recovery of the adult flukes confirm sa diagnosis. Alright? Now, treatment is still the same, tricla or triclabendazole. Okay? Alright. Because again, as I mentioned, the eggs of Fasciola and Fasciolopsis are they're really similar. And dili nimo siya ma-differentiate from each other. Okay? Please take note. Alright. Okay. Sige. So that's for the Fasciola species, the first group of your liver flukes, okay? So again, same regapon, Fasciola gigantica, what you need to remember, common names, infective stage, mode of transmission, the intermediate hosts, okay? Please take note, and also the disease, no? So liver-related, japon, okay? All right. Before I proceed to the next, any questions? Okay. Lang kaya pa. Kaya today, laban lang. Alright. Now, in the Philippines, fasciola, human infections, no? Wala kayo yung na-recover. There is no known now, no known endemic case of fasciolysis in the Philippines, human fasciolysis. If naaman gani, usually it's from foreigners, okay, na imported sa gawas, okay? Meaning, nakuha nilang infection sa gawas, and then there is a Philippines na detect, okay? Pero if endemic yun siya sa Philippines, it's not endemic in the Philippines, ang fasciola, no? So, at least, wala siya dito, okay? Wala yung mga human infections kaayo, alright, okay, sige. Alright, because siguro naman, although we eat mga kangkong and all that, I think we make sure naman na the kangkongs are prepared correctly and properly, no? So, ato man siyang lutuon siguro, manang wala kahit na infections, alright? In some areas in the world, manggod, they eat it raw, like raw yun, na walay sagol, walay luto, no? So, ayan, possible na dito nakuha. Okay, alright, so, but in the Philippines, again, it's not endemic, ang fasciola species sa Philippines. Pero ang fasciola gigantica, it affects our water buffaloes, alright? But in humans, human infections, wala kaayo. Okay? Alright. Any questions, Zish, before we proceed? Alright? Okay, sige. So we now proceed to the next liver fluke, and that is your Clonorchis sinensis. Naku, dears, kanin yun, I have to emphasize. Okay? Your Clonorchis sinensis is known as the most important of all the liver fluke sa man. Okay? Actually, Clonorchis and Opisthorchis, because later, we'll know why. Pero siyang i-mention as the most important. Now, very important, I have to emphasize, dears, the common name, because ito ay recall sa aking board exam. As in, igawas yun siya, promise, sa akong board exam. Ako ang board exam, no? Last year, September 21, 22 siya. Happy 2 years to me. Charot, ayan. Sana all, nabot ang 2 years. Anyway, ayan, so, igawas pini siya. Ang question ato is, which of the following, or what is, or which of the following is the Chinese liver fluke? Nako, pagbasa dyan ako ato, yes, Lord, amen, praise the master, agad-agad. So that's why it's important for you to memorize na gyud ha, memorize gyud akong gi-require the common names by heart. Okay, kay usik ang 1 point yun. Para sa ako, di ba, sa board exam, if nalibog na ako, nalimot ako kung saan ang Chinese liver flow, wala na. No? So usik ang 1 point. So thankfully, naka-remember ako by God's grace. Ayan, and ang ato answer ana is, of course, Clonorchis sinensis. Please take note there. So Chinese liver fluke or the Oriental liver fluke. Please take note. Now, the habitat, as you can see, the bile duct or pwede po sa gallbladder. Final host is man and other mga species, animals that will eat fish. Ayan. First intermediate host is the snail, the Paraphosaurus species or Bulinus species or the Ganpang species of snails. Second intermediate host now is different, fish this time, freshwater fish. So, ito mga fish usually of the carp family, ito mga dagko na fishes. Okay, freshwater. Now, reservoir hosts are dogs, cats, pigs, mink, rats, and other mga mammals na mo-eat ng fish. Infective stage is metasearcharia. Mode of transmission is ingestion of fish. Raw or undercooked. Pwedeng pickled, salted, na basta raw. Hindi ko siya fully cooked. Okay? Alright, ayan. So, that's for Clonorchis sinensis. Now, for the adults, as you can see, it's more narrower. No? Medyo mas pataas siya ay narrower compared to your fasciola. Your fasciola magun is medyo wide, di ba? Now, for your adults, for Clonorchis, usually, again, they are quite slender, no? Mas sexy. No, dili mas slender siya, mas slender. Okay. So, narrower than the mid portion of the body. So, mas narrow sa iyang head kaysa sa iyang body. So, narrow and then medyo mo wide. Okay? Ayan. So, medyo inani ang appearance. Alright? So, again, muna mga parts. This is the oral sucker, cecum, intestine, ventral sucker. This is the uterus, the vitellaria sa kilid, and then these are the testes. Alright? And kanisa tunga ang ovary. So, again, ang testes ang nasa likod or posterior portion. Okay. Alright. Now, we go now for the eggs. Your eggs are operculated and mature. Meaning, paggawas niya sa environment, again, it's already containing a miracidio. Alright? Na siya'y larva agad-agad. Now, iyang appearance is described as similar to the appearance of an old-fashioned light bulb. Basta katong old na light bulb. Dili ka ng karon, no? Old-fashioned electric light bulb. Picture appearance, as you can see, mura siya pixel, alright? And very important, this one, na siya'y opercular shoulders. Ayan. So as you can see, maklaro yun din mo kung asang operculum, no? Ayan. So this one, ayan, na siya'y mga shoulders. Ayan, shoulders, okay? Opercular shoulders, okay? And opposite na operculum is a kama, or small knob na appendage, no? Ab-opercular. So, I say ab-opercular, opposite the operculum. Okay? So, opposite the operculum, na siya'y again, comma-shaped na appendage. Okay? Alright, ayan. So, that's for the egg of Ericlonorchis sinensis. Alright, okay. Again, what you have to remember, old-fashioned electric light bulb, picture-like appearance, opercular shoulders, nag-i-shay shoulders sa imuhang egg, no? Alright? And, nasa'y comma-shaped appendage sa opposite the operculum. So, operculum, and then opposite, aboopercular. Nasa'y comma-shaped appendage. Okay? Please take note. Alright. Now, don't be confused sa shoulders sa adult. Because ang shoulders sa adult, yung sama to, si Fasciola hepatica. But for eggs, no? Si Clonorchis sinensis. Nasa'y opercular shoulders. Okay? Please take note. Alright. Ayan. Sige. Now, for the life cycle, as you can see, similar again siya with your Fasciola species. But ang difference lang yun is a fish, no? Ang iyahang second intermediate host. Okay? So, the metacercari will insist on the flesh of the fish or pwede pong sa skin sa fish. Okay? And then, makaon sa humans or sa other hosts, no? Again, if makaon sila raw, pickled, no, salted na mga fish. Okay. Alright. Now, we go now to your symptoms and pathology for clonorchiasis. Because your clonorchis, again, as we have mentioned, resides in the bile duct, of course, the symptoms na ma-feel sa patient is related to biliary obstruction. So, pwede siyang mag-obstruct sa mga biliary ducts. Again, a similar japon, if light infection lang, gamayra ang worms na naa, there could be no symptoms, alright? But for heavy infections, there's of course abdominal discomfort and dull pain. Acute infections, if daghan ka yung metacercaria imong nakaon, okay? It could cause fever, chills, diarrhea, epigastric pain, and large liver and possibly jaundice within a month of ingestion. Now, again, why is it called the most important liver fluke? Because of its relation to cancer. Ayan, sa imuhang bile duct, cholangiocarcinoma. Because again, no, they reside in the bile duct, no? And in chronic infections, ayan, dugay na yun, narasig imuhang worms, imuhang bile duct. It can cause infection and it can cause changes in your bile duct, no? Your cholangitis, ayan, when you say cholangitis, na ay common bile duct stone plus biliary infection. Cholelithiasis is gallstone, meaning naagit sa gallbladder sulod. And cholangiocarcinoma is bile duct epithelium na cancer. Okay? And these complications can lead to death if hindi mo siya maagapan. Alright? Cholangiocarcinoma and hepatocellular carcinoma are the most important and serious na mga sequelae or mga complications. Alright? That's why it's called the most important liver fluke of man. Because again, there is a relation between cancer of the bile duct, cholangiocarcinoma, and liver to clonorchis. Now, there have been report, daghan kayo mga mechanisms na nung magka-cancer. But one of the postulates or one of the mechanisms is that for the longest time, chronic infections, there are worms in your bile duct. And once there are worms, dito, magsigig na inflammation, no? Inflammatory reaction from the body. And this will trigger changes in the epithelium, no? So, mga cells dito, it can cause hyperplasia, no? Kanang mga different cells, di ba? Different cell changes. And these cell changes are now more prone to carcinogens, no? Like mga sa food na ginakaon sa patient or sa environment po mismo. So, possible na dito makakuha ang patient ng cholangiocarcinoma if nas like clonorchis. Okay? So, possible daghang mechanisms. But again, murag ang starting point ato is the changes in the biliary tract epithelium because of the presence of the worms. Okay? So that's why it's called the most common liver fluke of man because of its association with cancer. No? Cholangiocarcinoma. Please take note of that. Okay. Alright. So that's for the symptoms and pathology of clonorchiasis. Okay? Alright. Now for lab BX, still the same routine ONP examination. Multiple samples may be needed. You examine now the mounts, your wet mounts under HPO because these eggs are quite smaller compared to your Fasciola and Fasciolopsis. So you have to examine it under HPO. Sedimentation techniques japon are recommended because this is operculated, so heavy ang egg, no? Mas musato siya sa ilalim. Do not add too much iodine, similar with your Fasciola, because again, they may stain darkly. String test or internal test can also be used because possible na the eggs are deposited in the duodenum. Higikan man siya sa gallbladder, di ba? So possible na ma-deposit sa duodenum, makuha siya sa string test. Eggs are not seen in feces in biliary obstruction, of course, because na-obstruct na ang biliary duct. So, possible na dili na mag-produce or ma-express or ma-present ang eggs to the intestine. So, therefore, wala kayo makuha ng eggs sa stool. Definitive identification is still the examination of adult worms. Now, treatment of choice is praziquantel, but for alternative drug is albendazole. Now, for the rest of your trematodes, except for Fasciola, usually the treatment of choice nato dears is praziquantel. Alright? The rest of your trematodes, except for fasciola. Alright? Atong treatment of choice kay albendazole, sorry, praziquantel. Okay? Alright. So that's for Clonorchis sinensis. Again, common name, ako lumabas sa board exam ko, recall, recall, prazobuzzer. Again, Chinese liver fluke. Alright. Okay. So that's for Clonorchis sinensis. Alright. Okay. Next, you have your Opisthorchis viverrini or viverrini. Alright. Now, Opisthorchis viverrini and Clonorchis are in the same family, no? They're in the same family group. Alright. Okay. Now, for Opisthorchis, usually they can be seen in Northeast Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, and sa Vietnam. Okay, so drang area. Sa Southeast Asia, ano? Common name is, this is the Southeast Asian liver fluke. Ayan, nasa pangalan na, Southeast Asian liver fluke. Habitat is same regard with Clonorchis. Final host is man. The first intermediate host is your snail, your Bithynia or Bithynia species. Second intermediate host pa rin is fish, parehas yapon with Clonorchis. Mode of transmission in infective stage, similar yapon with your Clonorchis. Alright? So it's in the same family, no? Opisthorchis and Clonorchis. Alright. Now, Clonorchis usually happens mangood, or ang Clonorchiasis usually ang ma-affect ka to mga Far East, no? Sa Japan, sa China, Korea, ditong napita. But for Opisthorchis viverrini or viverrini, usually sa Southeast Asia, no? Thailand, Laos, Cambodia, and also Vietnam. Okay? Alright. So sa areas pa lang, and a slight difference. Okay. Now, for the adults, as you can see, it's much more it's smaller than your C. sinensis adults. Ang difference natong lantawan is in the shape of your testes. Ayan. So later, ako na siyang isummarize. Okay? And it's transparent and of course, again, deep shape. Pero same this like appearance, same siya o shape with your Clonorchis sinensis. Alright. Now for the eggs, as you can see, similar po siyang appearance with Clonorchis. Okay? Lifespan can exceed 20 years. Okay? But same siyang appearance with Clonorchis, iyahang eggs. That's why we can also have a difficulty in identifying the egg, no, of Clonorchis and Opisthorchis because they can look the same. Alright? So how do we differentiate? We look lang at history, no? And if makakita tag adults, we look at the adults. Alright. Okay. Now for the life cycle, it's still similar. Again, very similar to your Clonorchis. But I have to emphasize, para sa Clonorchis, the eggs must first be ingested by the snail before mahatch ang mirasibyo, di ba? Unlike sa fasciola, na paggawa sa eggs sa imuhang water, mature siya, ang mirasibyo mo hatch and mo swim sa water padulong sa snail. For Clonorchis and Opisthorchis, the eggs must be ingested by the snail, alright? And inside the snail, dito na mo hatch ang mirasibyo. Alright? Nagets lang? Alright? And of course, the different larval stages, Miss RC, okay? And then, ang Sarcaria mo gawas, Sarcaria will go to the fish and mo insist into Metasarcaria and mo na makaon sa patient. Alright? Okay, so same siya with Clonorchis gyapon. Alright. Now, for symptoms, again, similar to the Clonorchis actually. So, biliary tract system, gyapon ang mga changes. Alright? Depending on worm burden, gyapon. If light infections, asymptomatic ng patient, kay gamay ra ang mga worms, can cause severe jaundice, cholangitis, hepatomegaly. So, mga liver-related. Same na gyapon siya with Clonorchis. And same with Clonorchis, cholangiocarcinoma ang most serious complication. So, Opisthorchis and Clonorchis, silang duhag yun ang related to cholangiocarcinoma. So, in a way, ilahang family ang most important liver fluke yun of man. But if you have to choose within the two, Clonorchis na lang. Okay? Clonorchis na itong answer. Because again, silang duha, for silang duhag yun, Clonorchis and Opisthorchis ang naay relation or association with cholangiocarcinoma or cancer. Okay? Alright. Ayan. So, that's for Opisthorchis viverrini. For LabDX, similar methods are with Clonorchis sinensis. Treatment of choice is still praziquantel. Alternative choice is mebendazole. Alright? Okay. Alright. Now, the last of your Opisthorchis species is Opisthorchis felineus. This Opisthorchis species is common sa mga Russia, drang dapita, no? Germany, Belarus, Kazakhstan. So, dito dapita sa Europe. Dito na dapit sa mga cold areas. Alright? And usually, ang gina-infect yung mga cats. Alright? That's why it's called the Siberian liver fluke or cat liver fluke. It's called Siberian liver fluke because this is common in Siberia also. Alright? But it's known as a cat liver fluke. Nasa pangalan na, felineus, di ba? Feline, cat. Cat liver fluke, Siberian liver fluke. Habitat is still the liver or biliary passages of the liver. Final host are your cats or kitagyapon. First intermediate host and second intermediate host, still the same, snail. And infective stage, mode of transmission, similar agyapon with Clonorchis and Opisthorchis viverrini. Alright, now for the adults, again, similar gyapon siya with the adults of O. viverrini. It's lancet shape, so same siya og lancet. Katong old na lancet na to ba? Katong reg katong metal, katong sakit sa deer's. I don't know if nakatry mo ato. Katong yung, katong feather na lancet, shucks, as in like, busa rin mo kaana, mudugo na siya forever ang fingers sa patient. Kinana siya ka-sharp, no? At sakit daw siya. Pero wala akong katry. Okay, yeah. Now, again, atong lantawan ang testes later sa differentiation sa tuluka adults na itong na-discuss. Alright. So again, they live attached to the biliary and pancreatic ducts of the host. Alright. Now for the eggs, again, similar gapon siya in appearance with your Opisthorchis and Clonorchis. Alright. But it's slightly narrower. Alright. And the shoulder is not clear. No, dili kayo klaro itong shoulder sa operculum pareha sa Clonorchis. Alright. So that's for the difference of the eggs. But again, generally, the morphology of the eggs are quite similar with Clonorchis and Opisthorchis. That's why it can be difficult to distinguish. All right. Okay. So for the life cycle, similar gyapon, Opisthorchis viverini, di ba? The eggs must be ingested first by the snail para until before mo hatch ang miracidium. All right. Okay. So kailan pa siya makaon sa snail? Okay. Now for symptoms and pathology, again, in contrast to C. sinensis and O. viverini, hepatitis-like and fever ang mga ma-feel sa patient, no, sa acute stage. It may resemble Katayama fever or also known as schistosomiasis, na fever, facial edema, lymphadenopathy, arthralgias, rash, and eosinophilia. And again, similar with Opisthorchis viverini, they can also lead to cholangiocarcinoma, chronic infections, no, and pancreas may also be involved, resulting in digestive problems. Okay? Alright, so, na yung mga, kaya again, as mentioned, di ba, there are ducts in the gallbladder na similar, or it same as the connection with the pancreas, so possible na ma-present po ang eggs or ang adult sa pancreas. Okay, alright. Now for lab DX, again, similar methods with Clonorchis sinensis and Opisthorchis viverini. Treatment of choice is praziquantel. And how do we differentiate? We look at the testes. Okay. For Clonorchis sinensis, branched ang testes. For Opisthorchis flineus, slightly lobulated. For Opisthorchis viverini, deeply lobulated. What we present? Ayan. Sige. So for Opisthorchis, for Clonorchis sinensis, muna siyang testes, as you can see, branch. No, na yung mga branches, Marshall 3. Okay, branched. Next, you have O. flineus, as you can see, lobulated. Meaning na yung mga lobes, no, na yung mga lobules, na yung mga lobes. Pero it's not that deep. Dili kayo klaro ang lobes, or medyo shallow lang. But for O. viverini, as you can see, ayan, deeply lobulated yun. Mas maklaro ang lobes, no? Mas maklaro ang murag mga mga lobes. Alright, so deeply lobulated ang testes sa O. viverini adult. Okay? So again, branched testes sa C. sinensis. You have slightly lobulated sa O. flineus and deeply lobulated sa O. viverini. So again, when you say lobulated, maklaro din ang mga lobes sa testes. Okay? So again, slight ra sa O. flineus, pero for O. viverini, naklaro din ang mga lobes. Okay? Sa testes. Alright? So that's for the comparison of the adults of Clonorchis and Opisthorchis. Alright? So it's through the adults usually that will help us, no? Identify them. Because the eggs, again, usually can be difficult to differentiate from one another. Alright? Okay, sige. And for the last of your liver flukes, your Dicrocelium dendriticum, no? Human infections are reported, pero rare ni siya, alright? And most of them are mga spurious infections, meaning ikaw nagyapon siya raw na sheep liver. So Dicrocelium, I'm sorry, wrong spelling, Dicrocelium hospis is responsible for human infections in Africa. So Dicrocelium dendriticum is known as the lancet fluke or lancet-shaped lanceolate fluke. All right. Habitat is the biliary passages of the liver gyapon. Final host is your sheep. Accidental host kita. First intermediate host is land snail. So different siya with the snails sa Fasciola and sa mga Clonorchis. Because ang Clonorchis, iyahang snails are sa water yun, aquatic. But for Fasciola is amphibious, pwedeng water or land. But for Dicrocelium, katulad yung mga land snails. And usually they release Cercaria in a mass of Cercaria known as the slime ball or germ ball. Alright? The second intermediate host is the ants, your Formica species. And infective stage is your Meta Cercaria. So mode of transmission is ingestion of the second intermediate host. So how do we get it, no? Ipakakontag ants, no? From food. Yan. So, or mga herbs or plants, no? So ayan. So possible tayo makakuha og Dicrocelium dendriticum sa mga Formica species na ants. I think ito niyang black na ants, if I'm not mistaken. Alright, okay. So what you have to remember lang, germ ball, slime ball of Cercaria. Okay. Muna siya ang yung i-release. Okay, sige. Now, for adults, as you can see, it looks like a lancet. Mamara siya lancet. Alright, so lancet shape, lanceolate shape adult fluke, all right? Now again, we're studying the bile ducts of the definitive host, kita or sa sheep or sa liver, sheep or sa mga cattle, all right? So again, oral sucker, ventral sucker, these are the testes and the ovary, vitellaria, and then the uterus ang likod. So as you can see, di ba, ang testes ang mas nauna kaysa sa ovary. So depende siya sa species, all right? Okay, all right. Now we have here the eggs. It's operculated, mature when laid, deep golden brown or dark brown yahang color, and it's resistant to drying. All right, so it's operculated, mature when laid. All right, so appeal na din siya sa shock. So may mo siyang SHOCD, shocked. Okay, all right. So that's yung mnemonic, shocked. Okay, all right. Now for the life cycle, as you can see, the eggs are still embryonated once released in the feces, but it has to be ingested first, again, by the snail. So same sa with Clonorchis and Opisthorchis. Now, this snail, inside the snail, magod, the snail will be irritated, no? And iyang i-release ng mga cercaria as a mass, no? Or germ ball, no? And this germ ball or slime ball is a collection of mucus from the respiratory system of the snail. Because again, na-irritate siya from the cercaria found in the egg, no? Yang i-release na siya to the environment as a slime ball, again, that is consisting of the cercaria na, all right, and mga mucus from the snail, all right, kaya na-irritate siya. And usually, ma-release niya siya or mabili na siya sa mga tract sa snail, di ba? Ang snail usually, if mulihok siya, naimurag mga liquid na mabilin, di ba? So, dira siya mabilin, okay? Ang imuhang slime ball. And again, this slime ball or germ ball consists of the cercaria. Now, this cercaria or slime ball, again, mag-crawl man ng ants, of course, so possible na makaon nila while eating some of the foods environment. Okay, and again, these ants, once ma-stuck siya sa ito mga sa plants or sa ito mga gikahon, once makaon na ito siya by the cows ba or sa humans accidentally, then that causes the infection. Alright? Okay, so what you have to remember, slime ball. Ayan, germ ball appearance. Slime ball, germ ball of cercaria. Okay. Alright. Now, symptoms and pathology, again, compared to Clonorchis of Opisthorchis, less severe ang effects sa imuhang dicrocilium. Alright? Mild symptoms lang siya. Symptoms may include chronic constipation and dyspepsia. If heavy ang infections, of course, it may lead to enlarged liver and jaundice. If intense ang infections, there could be colitis, cystitis, liver abscesses, and mga abdominal distress. There could also be systemic toxemia because ma-absorb sa body ang mga toxic metabolites sa worm. And eosinophilia is also absent in this infection. So, di kayo common ang eosinophilia. Alright, okay. Now, for lab BX, again, recovery of the eggs ito ang best na method from stool, bile, or duodenal drainage specimens. Presumptive infection, you have to differentiate again it from spurious infection. So, similar siya with fasciola. So, to differentiate spurious infection from true infection, you let the patient be free of liver, no, sa iyang diet, all right, and then you examine the stool after mga 3 days, all right. Definitive diagnosis is still recovery of the adult worms in your specimen, surgery or autopsy, and the treatment of choice is still praziquantel. Okay, all right. So that's for Dicrocilium dendriticum, and those are all for your liver flukes, all right. So before I proceed to the last group for today, do you have any questions, dears? Nandiyan pa ba kayo? Okay pa ba? Can I get an amen? Charot. Buta na pa mo, dear. Okay pa ba mo? Or yes? Wala na kayo? How are you all? Nandiyan pa ba kayo?
Nara, sir.
Nara, sir.
Salamat. Salamat sa assurance. Charot. And sa validation. Okay. Alright. So, ayaw ko biyayin. Charot! Kapoy na mabiyan. Ah, eme, eme. Charot, charot. Okay, sige. So any questions before I proceed to the last group, your intestinal flukes? Alright. So I'm wondering, ano ang uban wala naka-join? Siguro sa ilahang face-to-face, na yung uban na whole day. Alright? Kaya ako na naibalan is katong block lang Sophia. Alright? Perlans lang Earl, silang Alzen. Kapakayo ni Duman sila. So medyo nag-wonder lang ako. But anyway, alright. Anyway, so any questions? Again, kinsa to ang Chinese liver fluke? Press the buzzer.
Clonorchis immune system.
Ayan. Dapat agad-agad, ha? Ayan. Baka, nako-recall dito siya, dears. Wala ko ga-joke, promise. Wala ko ga-joke, promise. No, lumabas talaga siya sa boards ko. Okay? Alright. So, na-shock ni ko na, ha? Inani ka trivial, no? Inani ka simple na question. Nigawa siya sa boards. Kaya I was expecting ko yung mga intense-intense, no? Pero nigawa siya, thankfully. Thank God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. No? So baka sa inyo, lahi na common yung mga nigawas. Example, the lancet fluke or lanceolate fluke. Kinsa man siya? bagal. The Lancet fluke or lanceolate fluke, kinsa man eh. Wala, bago na ganitan ako man. Kinsa ni? Lanceolate or lancet-shaped fluke? C?
Like crocodile yung...
Okay, dicrocelium, cilium, dendriticum. Okay, alright. Ayan. Diba yan? Dears, ha? Malapit natin matapos sa para. So, ito ba? Answer po mo. Ay, magkaulaw. Baklang to. Pero pa mo maulaw na hapit na mamanan SEM. Charot. Whoa! Excited ako mamanan SEM. Charot. Okay. Ayan, no? So, please, no? Try na mag-answer, alright? Okay, ano na? Hapit na mo mag-para. So, try your best to answer mga iba dyan. Okay? Alright. Para natin interaction on MM. Alright. So, that's for the liver fluke. So, within itself, these are flukes that mostly affecting the liver, no? So sa mga liver flukes at si ano ni siya, si flukes belen, high fluid, okay. Now we go to the last group for today, and that is your intestinal flukes, starting first with your Faciolopsis buschi. Now Faciolopsis buschi is known as the largest fluke parasitizing man. It's really big, no? Dax Swedish siya, all right? So nasa pangalan na, common name niya is your giant intestinal fluke. Now, it resides in your small intestine. The final host are is man, kita. First intermediate host is still the snail, like na species, Segmentina, Hippeutis. Second intermediate host are still mga water plants and water vegetation. Pwede gyapon si kangkong, pero aside from that, you have water chestnuts, caltrops, and bamboo shoots, alright? Infective stage, mode of transmission, similar gyapon, metasarcaria, ingestion of the second intermediate host, alright? So, that's for Faciolopsis buschi. So, pangalan na parang buschi, di ba? When you say buski, marag busok. Ayan, di ba? So, busok, buski. So, it's big. Faciolopsis. Alright. Largest fluke parasitizing man. So, muna siya yung mga first intermediate, second intermediate host. You have water caltrops and water chestnuts. I'm not sure if nakakaon ba kuhanis of Philippines. Or basta nila ko tikaw ginani. Lagi ako ginakaon. Charot. I'm not sure if nakakaon kuhanis. Pero again, these are plants na nag-reside sa water. And we also have here, of course, bamboo shoots. No? So, the bong in Bisaya, di ba? I'm sure you're familiar with that. Usually, ginabutang niya siya sa mga utan na to, di ba? Utan, okay, di ba? Na yung kinani, bamboo shoots, alright? Aside from eating them raw, patients may also get it if kanang paako nila niya siya, like itir, no? Itir ang covering sa bamboo shoots using their teeth. Pwede lang makuha na, okay? Accidental ingestion, alright? So, hindi siya mga possible second intermediate host of Faciolopsis buschi, alright? So for the adults, as you can see, it could be fleshy, dark red, and very, very important, opposite to fasciola hepatica, wala siya shoulder. So smooth ra diretso, di ba? Smooth, wala siya murag kato, murag protrusion din na shoulder. Okay? So no shoulder, shoulder, head and, sana, kanasa ko melon, charot. Ayan, so no shoulder, alright, compared to your F hepatica. They live attached to the bowels, the small intestine, primarily duodenum and jejunum. Your lifespan seldom exceeds 6 months to a year. So, pwede na siyang mawala, okay? Because of treatment. So, di siya mag-extend for a long period of time. Sana all, charot. Parehas niya, dili mo dugay, eme. Now, for the adults, ayan, these are the structures. Again, still the same, oral sucker, ventral sucker, the uterus with the eggs, ovary, and the testes, and ang vitellaria sa kilid. Alright? Again, wala siya shoulder. Diba? So, you can see, very smooth lang, diretso lang iyahang body. No? Ano lang yun, okay? Alright, sige. Now, for the eggs, again, as you can see, as I have mentioned, the eggs of Faciolopsis and Fasciola species are indistinguishable from each other. Okay? They have the same appearance with the egg. Pero, ang imuhang Faciolopsis buschi, the operculum is quite small, dito kayo klaro, alright? And if less mature ang egg, there is no breaks na makita. Meaning, unsay breaks, unsay pasabot ng breaks, sir, kanang muhunong, charot, dili. Dili maklaro na naay murag mga partition diri. Murag dili jud maklaro na diri ang operculum ba. Unlike sa mga fasciola and also clonorchis, makita gyud nimo na naay murag line diri sa taas, di ba? Na murag breaks, meaning mao gyud ang operculum. All right? Kung less mature ang egg, mas dili klaro to na break or line na makaingon ka na okay muli siyang operculum. All right? Okay. But again, the eggs of Faciolopsis fasciola are indistinguishable from each other because again, they look the same. All right. But usually, Faciolopsis buschi are quite larger, okay, compared to the Fasciola species. Again, similar with Fasciola species, it's immature when laid, alright? Operculated, immature when laid. Now, life cycle, similar gapon siya with your Fasciola, pero ang difference lang is that sa small intestine na siya magpuyo, okay? Hindi siya mumigrate, hindi siya mu-add to sa liver, alright? Okay, ayan. So here's this life cycle. Again, impregnated eggs, similar with Fatsiola species. Again, impregnated eggs, muhatch ang metasidium. Alright? Okay, muhatch ang metasidium ha, sa water. The metasidium will swim padulong sa snail. Alright? Again, opposite to Crinorchis and Opisthorchis na kailangan muna makaon sa snail ang egg before muhatch ang metasidium. For Fatsiola, Fatsiolopsis, the eggs hatch in the water na gyud, and the metasidium will swim to the snail. Alright? The snail, inside the snail, the metasidium develops Miss RC. Cercaria will be released. Cercaria again will insist on plants, okay, all right, as metacercarii, and will be infected or ingested by humans or pigs, all right. And inside the duodenum, mugawas ang metacercaria, all right, and will mature into adults, okay, all right, and the small intestine, okay, all right. Now for the symptoms and pathology, similar gapo depends on worm burden. If gamay ra ang worms, light infections lang, pero kung heavy infections, pwede siyang mo-spread to the stomach and most of the intestinal tract. Okay. Now, attachment, di ba? Because again, nasa yung mga suckers, si hilig siyang suck. So meaning, mo-attach siya sa walls yung mga intestines. So it can cause inflammation, mucus, no? Mucus production, hemorrhage, ulceration, and possible abscess formation. Okay? Alright. Now, in heavy infections, similar siyang appearance or similar siyang symptoms to Charge. It can proceed or it can produce malabsorption because again, the adult worms are attached to the surface of the small intestine. So therefore, nana yung mga nag-hinder sa small intestine, mag-disor nag-absorb ang body o mga nutrients. So it can lead to malabsorption. It can lead to bowel obstruction also, and the body can also absorb the toxic metabolites of the worms. Kinahatash gyud siya sa imuhang small intestine na wall. So kato mga toxic metabolites, waste products sa imuhang worms, ma-absorb po sa body, which can lead to ascites, mga infections sa sulod, and edema. Stools are again profuse, meaning liquid din siya, frothy, no? Could be steatorrhea na apod, yellow, green, and contain increased amounts of undigested food because again, malabsorption. So possible siya na mimic og symptoms similar to Giardia, giardiasis, and capillaria because of malabsorption. Vitamin B12 absorption is also impaired. There is marked eosinophilia and leukocytosis are also seen. Alright. Now, edema of the face may occur because of hypoalbuminemia, again, because of malabsorption or protein-losing enteropathy. Because again, the small intestine is blocked, di ba? Ang surface of small intestine is blocked by the adult worms na naka-attach. So therefore, ang imuhang nutrients mag-reason at sulod sa small intestine, which can lead to malabsorption and again, hypoalbuminemia. So if wala na proteins, wala na albumin, di ba? It can lead to edema. Alright, okay. Ayan. And for the lab BX, routine stool examination pa rin, and diagnostic stage are the eggs. Adults are rarely seen and usually seen lang siya in heavy infection. Sedimentation techniques are FECT na gyapon are recommended. Your zinc sulfate is not recommended because, ayan, na explanation din eh, the high specific gravity of zinc sulfate will make the egg open, no? Mo-pop open ang imuhang egg. So, mo-open ang operculum, the egg will be filled by the zinc sulfate fluid. So what happens is, mo-sink siya sa ilalong. So if mugamit ka ng zinc sulfate, as we have already mentioned, the zinc sulfate flotation, you have to examine both the surface and the sediment. Okay? But for trematode eggs, usually, ang best good nato is sedimentation techniques. Because again, these are heavy eggs. They have operculum. Alright. Eggs are identical with the eggs of Fatsiola, also Echinostoma, and Gastrodiscoides hominis. So there could be a difficulty in differentiation. So the treatment of choice is still praziquantel. Niclosamide is your alternative. Okay. All right. And the last fluke for today is your echinostomids. For echinostomids, very important lang to remember is that ang ilang oral sucker, ilang mouth is surrounded by a circumoral, what do you call this, crown, no? Crown of spines or collar of spines. Okay, nasa yung mga spines, no? Or collarette of spines in a disc surrounding the oral suckers. Now, common name is your Garrison fluke because this was discovered by Garrison. And it was discovered among Bilibid prisoners in the Philippines, no? So, Garrison fluke. Habitat is small intestine. Final host is kita, man. Could also be dogs, cats, or pigs. So, kani siya, si Echinostoma deer, siya yun ang ganahan sa snail, okay? Siya yun ang snail lover because both first and second intermediate host kay snail. Ayan. So, you don't have to be confused or you don't have to worry kung siya ang second intermediate host because both of them are snail. Alright, okay. Infective stage, mode of transmission, similar gapon, metacercarii, and ingestion of the second intermediate host, raw, usually. So in the Philippines, this is common. This is endemic in the Philippines. Because again, there are areas, especially sa Luzon, na magkaon-og mga raw na mga snails, no? So butangan nila og kataranggata, no? Milk, coconut milk and also vinegar, ilan ang kanon. Pero when you do that, a metasurcaria found in the snail will not die, no? Makasurvive sila sa vinegar and also sa coconut milk. So possible na makuha ra gyud Japanese mga infection. Pero lami kini siya, dear's promise. I haven't tried, no, pero the fact na naigata lang siya. Okay, all right. Yeah, samot na what if spicy. Ah. Anyway, ayan, malapit na kasi ang lunch. Okay, anyway. Alright, sige. So that's for Echinostoma ilocanum. Okay, alright. Now, for the adults, as you can see, it's reddish gray, tapered at the posterior end. Now, again, as mentioned, common to the Echinostoma species, the oral sucker is surrounded by a circumoral, meaning nag-surround siya, simong oral sucker, a collar of spines or crown of spines. 49 to 51 ang Echinostoma ilocanum. Okay, that's very important. Distinct yun sa mga Echinostoma species. Okay? Echinostoma ilocanum. Alright, okay. So I think that's also ilocanum kayo na-discover siguro siya sa Ilocos, no? Or Ilocano bang na-discover? Basta related to the Philippines. It was discovered in Bilibid prisoners, no? In the Philippines. Okay. Alright, ayan. Now, the eggs are ellipsoidal or yellow-brown, according to Garcia. But for Belisario, it's ovoid or straw-colored. Please take note lang that the operculum is not prominent, dili siya klaro, okay? And it's still operculated, immature when laid, no? FFPE, di ba? Appears sa FFPE. And there is a thickened abopercular end. So opposite sa operculum, na merong thickening sa abopercular end. Alright? Okay. Now for the symptoms and pathology, light infections, again, patient may be symptomatic, only minor problems. Heavy infections, of course, catarrhal inflammation, ulceration, also may lead to bloody diarrhea and abdominal pain if they can't kayo. Of course, diba, na may spines, ang muhang oral sucker. So possible makakontribute to the sa ulceration sa muhang intestine. So pwedeng bloody muhang diarrhea. Absorption of metabolites, similar with your fasciolopsis, can also happen, which may lead to intoxication of the patient. Laboratory diagnosis, similar methods with F. Buschi. And the treatment is praziquantel or tetrachloroethylene ang alternative. Alright. And the last among the echinostomates is your Artif echinostomum malayanum. Alright. Reservoir hosts are rats. Similar with your Echinostoma ilocanum, both the first and second intermediate hosts are snails. Infective stage, motor transmission, similar to metasurcarii and ingestion of the snails na raw. Alright. Now adults are rounded ang posterior end. 43 to 45 ang color spine, so mas little ang ihang spines compared to Echinostoma ilocanum. The eggs are also golden brown, operculated, and larger than your E. ilocanum. So quite rare lang siya. Small number of fatal cases have been reported. Heavy worm burden yapon that led to anemia, malnutrition, or intestinal perforation. Because again, of the spines, and mo attached sa imong intestine. Okay? So it can lead to malabsorption, anemia, and all that. Alright, but again, small cases have been reported lang. For Artifact Echinostomum malayanum. So Echinostoma and Artifact Echinostomum malayanum, we have that in the Philippines, no? There have been cases of it, all right? But for Fasciola and Fasciolopsis, wala sa Philippines, it's not endemic to the Philippines, or wala kayo'y human infections of the two. For Clonorchis and Opisthorchis, also wala kayo siya sa Philippines, all right? But there have been one case of Opisthorchis na nakitaan sa Davao, daw, while surgery sa biliary tract, nakitaan nila ang Opisthorchis na adult, okay? And for Clonorchis in the Philippines po, duha ka cases daw were reported, pero these are foreigners na na-import nilang infection from Gawas, okay? So, again, generally, dili siya endemic sa Philippines, ang Opisthorchis and Clonorchis, alright? But the Echinostoma and Artific Echinostomum, it's endemic in the Philippines, okay? We have this here, alright? Okay. And here's the adult of your Artific Echinostomum. As you can see, rounded ang posterior end, no? Round, alright? And as yung mouth, again, ay color of spine, similar with the Echinostoma ilocanum. And this is the Miracidium, dears, letter D, okay? Miracidium ni siya. And this is the egg of Artific Echinostomum, no? It's larger compared to Echinostoma, okay? And this is the Miracidium, no? So, again, it's inside a cyst-like structure, alright? And the inside are the developing trematode. So, pag kaon sa metasurcaria, mugawas ni siya, okay? Muhatch na siya outside, and then mumigrate, alright? Sa fasciola. Pero for intestinal trematodes, mureside na siya sa intestine, okay? Alright, that's for the echinostomids. Echinostoma ilocanum and Artific Echinostomum malayanum, alright? And that's all for today. Yes, for tomorrow, we're going to continue with the flukes. Medyo marami naman tayo na discuss sa flukes. Okay. Any kapoy na ko? Charat. Okay. Laban lang. All right. Sige. Before we leave, dears, any questions?